science, physics.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. Mm. I'm Dr. Professor Matt Mock with Sports Science, and today we will be covering the physics of football. Dr. Professor Matt Mock here at the stadium, and today we're going to be discussing projectile motion using this football.
This is projectile motion. Physics!
Physics!
Now let's take what we just modeled on the field and bring it to the classroom as I model the projectile motion of the throw. So the throw is parabolic, so the ball travels in an arc. It is thrown here and hits Alex there. It traveled a distance of approximately 20 meters during the throw, and the throw took approximately 2 seconds. So when you model projectile motion, it's most helpful to use a triangle to break it down into its vertical and horizontal components. So we'll model the triangle on this side. You have your right angle. So we already have all that we need to find in order to get the horizontal component of this. We just need to find the speed that the ball traveled. So velocity equals distance over time. So the velocity would be 20 meters over 2 seconds. So the ball traveled at 10 meters per second. And the ball reached its highest point at approximately 1 second into the throw, because the highest point would be the midpoint of the throw. So in order to find the vertical component, we need to look at one of the acceleration formulas, which is A equals VF, V final minus V initial over time. So we already know the acceleration of gravity is negative 9.8 meters per second squared is going to equal VF. At the top of the throw, it's about to start coming back down, so the final velocity is 0 meters per second minus V initial, which is what we're trying to solve for, over time. And we've already established that the time is about 1 second. So rearranging this formula using simple algebra, we see that 0 minus VI equals negative 9.8 meters per second. So negative VI equals negative 9.8. So VI equals 9.8 meters per second. Now we just use the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared, and add these two sides together, so you get 100 plus 96.04 equals 196.04. The square root of 196.04 is about 14 meters per second. So the ball was launched at 14 meters per second by Tanner. Today we will be measuring the 40-yard dash, which is a key component in measuring an athlete's performance because it shows the peak speed which they can reach during a football game.
Hi, I'm Alex Wynn, and this is the 40-yard dash. I'm 6 feet and I weigh 274 pounds. Physics.
Time is 6.9 seconds. This is Tanner Seaburger, and this is the 40-yard dash. I'm 5'7", and I weigh 145 pounds.
Five point five seconds. Physics.
will now be calculating our athlete's average speed over the 40-yard dash. We're going to be using the formula for velocity, v equals distance over time. So first we're going to calculate Alex's average speed. So v equals, we're all going to be doing this in feet, by the way. V equals 120 feet over 6.9 seconds. So his velocity is about 17.4 meters per second. And we'll be doing the same thing for Tanner. V equals 120 over 5.5. Tanner's average velocity was 21.8 meters per second. So you can see that Tanner was clearly much faster than Alex.
Hey, Dr. Professor Matt Mock here, and now we're going to be covering the tackle, which is all about momentum. In physics, linear momentum or translational momentum is the product of mass times velocity.
This is when the ball carrier has more momentum than the tackler. Physics! This is when both the tackler and the ball carrier have the same momentum.
Physics. My nipple.
This is when the tackler has more momentum than the ball carrier.
Now we're going to be using the speed, which we just found, in order to find our athletes' momentums. Momentum in football is important to determine who will win in a head-on-head tackling situation. So here we have our athletes' velocities, and we have their weights, which is important because the formula for momentum is P equals MV, which is momentum equals mass times velocity. So first we'll calculate Alex's momentum. We see that he moved at 17.4 meters per second, so he had P equals 17.4 times his 275 pounds. And we get that P equals 4,782 foot-pounds per second. Now we'll be calculating Tanner's average momentum. So we're going to do the same steps. P equals 21.8 times 145. And we see that Tanner's momentum is 3,163 foot-pounds per second. So if Tanner and Alex were tackling each other, you see that because Tanner's momentum is less and Alex's is greater, Alex will overtake Tanner in a head-on collision. So now we're going to be talking about Newton's first law, which states that an object in motion tends to remain in motion until acted upon by an external force, similar to what you just saw. This relates to football in that a ball carrier tends to remain running at a high speed with the ball until stopped by an external force, which is a linebacker or a defensive tackle.
Physics.
This is Rainer Osmus, quarterback of the Klein Bearcats, and this is Projectile Motion.
Physics. Well, that's basically, Matt, physics is the real Matt.
Really?
Alright, this is Dr. Professor Matt
Wilson. Matt, stop dropping the ball!
This is Projectile Motion.
Hi, this is Dr. I always look away.
Beautiful. That's working.
Hey guys, it's working.
Yeah.